Hi students, already we have studied how can find out roots of one quadratic equation using by factorization method. Then second method is completing square method. Total three methods are there. First factorization method, in previous video already we have discussed. Then second method is completing square method. Before starting this method, you have to study two formulas. Already you have studied in lower class. First formula is a plus b whole square. That is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Then second formula is a minus b whole square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. Now we can start exercise 4.3. Question number 1. Find the roots of quadratic equations if they exist. We cannot find out the roots of all the quadratic equations. Sometimes we will get no solution. At that time we cannot find out. By the method of completing square, we have to use in here completing square method only. Don't use factorization method. Okay. Or other method. We can use only completing square method, because in this question they already mentioned use completing the square method, isn't it? Then how can do? Roman number 1, 2x square minus 7x plus 3 equal to 0. We can see in here one constant. Constant means without x. Which number? That 3, isn't it? Plus 3. First this plus 3 bring to a right side. 2x square minus 7x, this plus 3, if you bring to right side, that will be minus 3. Plus change it to minus. That is first step. Second step is the coefficient of x square, we need 1. What we will do? We will divide all the equation by 2. That is 2 divided by 2. What you will get in here? 1, isn't it? That is second step. The coefficient of x square, make 1. Can write divide by 2. Divide by 2 all the equation. And we can write 2x square divided by 2, 7x divided by 2, minus 3 divided by 2. Just cut it 2 and 2. Then remaining only 1, isn't it? X square minus 7 by 2x equal to minus 3 by 2. Then, next step, very important step, that is adding, we are going to add one term, adding 1 by 2 into, in here, the coefficient of x, without sign, which number? 7 by 2, don't take minus 7 by 2, only take it that 7 by 2, coefficient of x, 7 by 2. 1 by 2, then coefficient of x without sign, plus or minus whole square. We are going to add one extra term. 1 by 2 always we will use. The square also we will use. This 7 by 2 means coefficient of x on both sides. That time, how can I write? X square minus 7 by 2x. If you add left side, 1 by 2 into 7 by 2 whole square equal to, right side also you have to add same term, 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 7 by 2 whole square. Why we are adding this term means we have to make a plus b whole square, otherwise a minus b whole square, that form. For that purpose only, I just add one term in here. Then x square minus 7 by 2x plus, we can multiply this term, that is 1 into 7, 7, then 2 into 2, 4 whole square. X square minus 7 by 2x plus 1 into 7, 7 by 2 into 2, 4, 4 square equal to, right side also minus 3 by 2 plus, multiple, 1 into 7, 7, isn't it? 7 square you can take. 7 square will be 7 into 7, 49. Divide by denominator, 2 into 2, 4, then take square, 4 square, 4 into 4, 16. Then, check it left side. In here, a square minus this part is 2ab plus b square. That time, what is a? A means x, then b means 7 by 4. That time, a square, this is b square. This is 7 by 2x, that is 2ab. Check it, 2ab, 2 into a means x into b means 7 by 4. 4 and 2 cancel, 2. Then what is remaining? 7 by 2x. 7 by 2x. Can you see 7 by 2x in here? That means 7 by 2x means 2ab. That time we can apply this formula. A minus b also. A in here, x minus b means 7 by 4. 7 by 4. Then square, all square. Equal to right side, take LCM. What is LCM? 16. 16, then minus 3 into, already 2 is there. 2 into 8, 2 into 8, 16 you will get. Use same 8 up there also when you take LCM. Minus 3 into 8 plus 49. You don't have to multiply using by any number because 16, we have written 16 only, no difference. X minus 7 by 4 equal to, we can multiply, minus 3 into 8, minus 24, then plus 49 divided by 16. In here one square, you can see that square bring to right side, that will be square root. X minus 7 by 4 equal to, minus 24 plus 49, that is 49 minus 24, 49 minus 24, 5, 2, 25 will get, isn't it? 49 is positive number, that's why we get at plus 25, divided by 60. X equal to square root of 25 is 5, divided by square root of 16 is 4. When you take square root, you have to use plus or minus. Plus or minus. Plus or minus 5 by 4. The left side, you can see minus 7 by 4. Bring to right side, that will be plus 7 by 4. Then remaining part, I am going to write in here. X equal to, in here also, this plus or minus we can give separately. First give plus. Plus 5 by 4, 7 by 4, or x equal to, give minus, minus 5 by 4, 7. X equal to, take LCM, LCM is 4, isn't it? Then 5 plus 7, you can write 12, or x equal to 4, 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 is 2. X equal to, cut it, in 12, for how many times? 3 times, is it? And by 3. X equal to, in here, this is by 2. We can simplify that, we'll get 1 by 2. Now we got roots of given quadratic equation. Therefore, roots of a given quadratic equation are, first root is 3 and second root is 1 by 2. This is our answer. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Next question, that is Roman number 2. Using by completing square method, we have to find out roots of given quadratic equation. We can start. Here already given one quadratic equation, we can write that first. Then what is first step? First step, the constant bring to right side. What is constant in here? Minus 4, isn't it? This minus 4 bring to right side, that will be plus 4. 2x square plus x equal to 4. Minus 4 bring to right side, that will be plus 4. Then second step is the coefficient of x square, make it 1. How can make in here 1? This all the equation just divide by 2, isn't it? Divide by 2. That time we can write 2x square divide by 2, x divide by 2, 4 divide by 2. 2 and 2 cancel, then remaining x square, x divide by 2, this 2 cancel. Now we got x square plus x by 2 equal to 2. Then we have to add both sides one term. Which term that? Keep in mind that this is the main step in this question. Adding 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 always we will use. What is coefficient of x in here? Coefficient of x is, you write 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is the coefficient of x, isn't it? Then write 1 by 2 whole square on both sides. This 1 by 2 only will change. Other first 1 by 2 and square always we will use. This 1 by 2 means the coefficient of x. In previous question that is 7 by 2. Not minus 7 by 2 in previous question. Okay. We cannot use this plus or minus. Always we will use plus. Okay. Then x square plus x by 2 plus 1 into 1. Otherwise we can write same. First step. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 all square. Right side 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 all square x by 2 plus 1 into 1, 1, then 2 into 2, 4. We will get 1 by 4 all square. Right side 2 plus 1 into 1, 1. 1 square is 1. 2 into 2, 4. 4 square is 4 into 4, 16. Then check it left side. What is this? This is a square plus 2ab plus b square. What is a in here? A in here, x. A means x. There. What is b? B means last term. That is 1 by 4. 1 by 4. Then this x divided by 2. What is that? That is 2ab. You can check. Check it 2ab. 2ab equal to 2 into a means x. B means 1 by 4. This 2 cut it, 2 will get. Then x into 1, x divided by 2. X by 2, that's middle term, isn't it? This is x divided by 2 is 2ab. Then, that time we can use a square plus 2ab plus b square. What is that? A plus b all square. X. X plus b means 1 by 4. All square equal to. Right side, take LCM. LCM in here, 16. 16. Then this 2 multiple 2 into 16 plus 1 plus this 1 x plus 1 by 4 all square equal to 2 into 16 32. Check it. 16 2. 2 into 6 12. Remainder 1. 2 into 1 2 plus 1 3. 32 plus 1 divided by 60. Then from left side x square bring to right side. X plus 1 by 4 equal to 32 plus 1, 33 divided by 16. This square become square root. X equal to square root of 33. We cannot find out, just write square root of 33 plus or minus you have to use. Then divide by square root of 16 is 4. This plus 1 by 4 bring to right side, that will be minus 1 by 4. X equal to first give plus plus root 33 divided by 4, then minus 1 by 4. Or second answer is u minus minus root 33 divided by 4 and minus 1 by 4. X equal to, take LCM. What is LCM in here? 4, isn't it? In second part also, 4 is LCM. You can write 4. Root 33 minus 1 or x equal to minus root 33 minus 1 divided by 4. We got now solution, that means roots. Therefore, roots of a given quadratic equation are, first root is root 33 minus 1 by 4, then second root is minus root 33 minus 1 divided by 4. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now we can see Roman number 3. In here also, using by completing square method, we have to find out roots. Then we can start. Then, what is first step? First step is the constant term bring to right side. That is, plus 3 bring to right side. That will be minus 3. 4x square plus 4 root 3x minus 3. That is first step. Then, second step is the coefficient of x square, make it 1. How can make in here 1? Just divide by 4. Divide by 4, that time 4x square divided by 4, 4 by 4 root 3x divided by 4 minus 3 by 4. That's 4, 4 cut it in here also, 4 and 4 cancel. Then remaining x square plus root 3x equal to minus 3 by 4. Then next step, we have to add one term on both sides. Can write adding. Always we will write which number? 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into the coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x in here? Root 3. Root 3, then whole square. This term we will add in on both sides. X square plus root 3x plus 1 by 2 into root 3 all square. Right side also, right? Same term. Then x square plus root 3x plus 1 into root 3, root 3 divided by 2. Whole square equal to minus 3 by 4 plus 1 into root 3, root 3. Root 3 square is root 3 into root 3. That will be 3 divided by 2 square. 2 square is 2 into 4. In left side you can see a square plus 2ab plus b square. What is a? A in here, x. B means root 3 by 2. A means x, b means root 3 by 2. Then this root 3x, what is that? That is 2ab. You can check 2ab. 2ab is 2 into a means x into b means root 3 by 2. 2, 2 cancel. Then remain x into root 3. Root 3x. Root 3x, 2ab, isn't it? Then that time left side we can write a plus b whole square. A means x plus b means root 3 by 2 all square equal to right side minus 3 by 4 plus 3 by 4. That will be 0. Minus and plus, isn't it? 0. X plus root 3 by 2 equal to the square bring to right side. That will be square root of 0. X equal to square root of 0. 0 only, Then this plus root 3 by 2 bring to right side, that will be minus root 3 by 2. We got x value is minus root 3 by 2. Therefore, roots of a given quadratic equation is minus root 3 by 2 and minus root 3 by 2. We got only one answer. We have to write this x equal to minus root 3 by 2 two times, because you know the number of solution any quadratic equation is 2, otherwise no solution. You will get 2 solution, otherwise no solution. We got only one solution, that means 2 equal solutions, right? 2 times same answer. Now we can see Roman number 4. In here also, using by completing square method, we have to find out roots of this quadratic equation. Here, already given one quadratic equation, we can write first that 2x square plus a. This constant bring to right side. What is constant in here? 4, isn't it? That 4 bring to right side, that will be minus 4. 2x square plus x equal to minus 4. Then second step is, in here the coefficient of x square we have to make 1. That's why this all the equation divided by 2. Divide by 2. 2x square divided by 2. X divided by 2. Minus 4 divided by 2. 2 cancel. X square, x divided by 2. Right side also you can simplify. 4 divided by 2. 2 minus 2. Then adding. Which time we will add on both sides? 1 by 2 into, always we will use 1 by 2. Then coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? That is 1 by 2 here. 1 is there. Then 1 divided by 2. 1 by 2, then square on both sides. Only this term only will change. 1 by 2 and square always we will use. All the problems when you use completing square method. X square, x divided by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 all square equal to minus 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 all square. X square plus x divided by 2 plus 1 into 1, 1 divided by 2 into 2, 4. 1 by 4 all square equal to minus 2 plus, in here 1 into 1, 1, 1 square. If you take 1 square, 1 into 1, 1 only you will get. Then 2 into 2, 4. 4 square, 4 square, 4 into 4, 16. Equal to, what is this? This is a square plus 2ab plus b square. We can write a plus b all square. A means x, b means 1 by 4 all square. Now you need to check always this x by 2. This middle term will be 2ab. If you near means you can check. In here a means x, b means 1 by 4. A means x, b means 1 by 4. Check it, 2ab. 2 into a means x, b means 1 by 4. This 2 cancel. What you will get? X into 1, x divided by 2. 2ab we got x divided by 2. X by 2, same. Right side. Take LCM. LCM is 16, isn't it? Then minus 2 into 16 plus 1. X plus 1 by 4 equal to, from left side square bring to right side, that will be square root. minus 2 into 16, minus 2 into 16 how much? Minus 32 plus 1, minus 32 plus 1 divided by 16, x plus 1 by 4 equal to square root of minus 32 plus 1, you will get minus 31 divided by 16. Then square root of any negative number we cannot find out, isn't it? That's why we cannot find out any solution, any root. Therefore, no solution. Already we have studied two methods. First method is factorization method. Second method is completing square method. Then one more method is there, that is using by quadratic formula. In here we will use one quadratic formula. You know, general form of quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to c. It is a quadratic equation because x square is the degree of this equation is 2. Then quadratic formula is x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Using by this formula we can find out roots of any quadratic equation. In here, b means coefficient of x, a means coefficient of x square, c is constant term. Then we will use this, all the values directly give in this formula, we will get roots of any quadratic equation. Number of solution in quadratic equation, sometimes we will get two solution, otherwise one solution, equal solution, otherwise no solution. You can see in here b square minus 4ac inside the square root. This b square minus 4ac will decide the number of solution any quadratic equation. In case b square minus 4ac is more than 0, that means any positive number. Any positive number, that time number of solution will be 2. We will get two different solution. In case b square minus 4ac equal to 0, equal to 0 means two equal solutions. That means only one solution, we will write two times, okay, two equal solution. Then b square minus 4ac less than 0, that means negative number. Negative number, that time no solution. B square minus 4ac positive means two different solution, b square minus 4ac 0 means two equal solution, then b square minus 4ac negative number means we will not get any solution, that is no solution. Then if the given one quadratic equation, directly no need to apply this formula. First we will find out b square minus 4ac, that positive means positive or 0 means we can find out solution, isn't it? In case negative means no need to find out solution, isn't it? Because we know no solution. Question number 2 is find the roots of quadratic equation by applying quadratic formula. Problem number 1, 2x square minus 7x plus 3 equal to 0. In here question number 2 we are using same question from question number 1. Okay. In question number 1 already given first equation is 2x square minus 7x plus 3 equal to 0. We will apply in here quadratic formula. In previous question, that is question number 1, we use completing square method, isn't it? Here 2x square 7x plus 3 equal to 0. What is a? A means coefficient of x square, that is 2. B means coefficient of x minus 7. Don't take plus 7 in here. Minus 7 is coefficient of x. C means constant term 3. First we will do b square minus 4ac. Find out b square minus 4ac. No need to use direct formula. First find out b square minus 4ac, that is positive or 0 means we can use. In case negative means no need to apply that formula. Directly we can write no solution. B square is minus 7 square minus 4 into ac. A is 2, c is 3. Minus 7 square, minus 7 into minus 7, minus into minus plus, 7 square is 49 minus 4 into 2, 8 into 3, 24 equal to 49 minus 24, 49, 24, 9 minus 4, 5, then 4 minus 2, 2, 25 you will get. We got b square minus 4ac 25, that is positive number. Positive number means you will get two different solution, two different roots, isn't it? Then now we can apply quadratic formula. The quadratic formula, write that formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Minus b. Minus, what is b? B is minus 7. Plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac already we got, that is 25. You can write that 25 divided by 2a. 2 into a in here, 2. Minus minus plus 7 plus or minus square root of 25 will be 5, divided by 2 into 2, 4. In here when you take square root of 25, no need to use plus or minus 5 because already plus or minus is there, isn't it? Then 7 plus 5 divided by 4 or 7 minus 5 divided by 4. 7 plus 5, 12 by 4. Or 7 minus 5, 2 by 4. Just to cut it, 3 will get 1, 2. 3 or 1 by 2. We got x values are 3 or 1 by 2. Therefore, roots of a given quadratic equation are 3 and 1 by 2. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Only one thing, study properly this formula. Then apply all the values A, B, C, then you will get answer. Now we can see Roman number 2 in here also, using by quadratic formula we have to find out roots of this quadratic equation. First we can write that given quadratic equation 2x square plus x minus 4 equal to 0. Then what is a in here? A means 2, b is in here 1, nothing means 1 is there, 1. C equal to minus 4. First we will find out b square minus 4ac. B square, b in here 1, we can write 1 square minus 4 into a is 2, c minus 4. 4 into s c 1 square. 1 square is 1 into 1. 1 minus minus plus 4 into 2. 8. 8 into 4. 32. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 4, 32. 1 plus 32, 33. 33 is a positive number. Positive number means we will get different solutions. Isn't it? By quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. X equal to minus b. Minus b means 1. Minus 1 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac is 33. Divided by 2a. A is 2. X equal to minus 1 plus or minus root 33 divided by 2 into 2, 4. We cannot find out square root of 33. You can write x equal to minus 1 plus root 33 by 4. Or minus 1 minus root 33 by 4. Therefore, roots of given quadratic equation are minus 1 plus root 33 by 4 minus 1 minus root 33 by 4. These are the roots of quadratic equation. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now we can see room number 3. In here we have to apply quadratic formula. Here, one quadratic equation given that we can write 4x square plus 4 root 3x plus 3 equal to 0. That is A. A in here 4, B 4 root 3, C is 3. First, we can find out B square minus 4ac. B square means 4 root 3 square. 4 into AC. A means 4. C is 3. Take square, 4 square. 16 into root 3 square. Root 3 into root 3, 3. Minus 4 into 4, 16 into 3. 16 into 3 minus 16 into 3. Same time, we will get 0 only. Isn't it? No need to multiply anything. By quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. X equal to minus, what is b? B in here, 4 root 3. Plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac, already we got it, 0. 2 into a is 4. X equal to plus or minus 4 root 3. Plus or minus 0, that is 0 only, isn't it? Square root of 0 is 0, nothing. No need to write 2 into 4. 2 into 4, 4, 4 cancel, then you will get x equal to minus root 3 by 2, minus root 3 by 2. Therefore, roots of given quadratic equation or we can write rho minus root 3 by 2 two times. Two equal roots, isn't it? Right, two times same roots. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now we can do Roman number 4. In here also, using by quadratic formula, we have to find out roots of given quadratic equation. Here, 2x squared plus x plus 4 equal to 0. That is A. A means coefficient of x squared, 2. B is coefficient of x, that is 1. C means constant term, 4. First, we can find out b square minus 4ac. B square is, b means 1. 1 square minus 4 into ac. A is 2. C. 1 square is 1 minus 2 into 4 into 2, 8 into 4, 32 equal to 1 minus 32 minus 31. We got b square minus 4ac is negative number. That means no solution, isn't it? You can write directly, therefore, no solution. No need to use that quadratic formula since b square minus 4ac answer negative. Now we can see question number 3. Find the roots of following equation. Roman number 1 is x minus 1 by x equal to 3, x not equal to 0. In here one condition given, x not equal to 0. If x equal to 0, what will happen? Just given this equation 0, 0 minus 1 by x means 0 equal to 3. 0 minus 0, no need to write. Then minus 1 by 0. Can you divide? 1 divided by 0. In 1, how many times 0? We cannot find out, isn't it? That's why 1 by 0 is not defined. So we cannot take x value is 0. That's why they are given already that condition, x cannot be 0. Then, it is a quadratic equation or not? In here, x square, not there, isn't it? First, we have to convert this equation as quadratic equation. What you will do? Take LCM. What is LCM in left side? Given x minus 1 by x equal to 3. LCM is x. X into x. You can multiply. X square minus 1 equal to 3. X square minus 1. This x bring to right side. That will be 3x. X square. 3x bring to left side. That will be minus 3x. Then minus 1. Equal to 0. Now we got one quadratic equation. We can find out roots from here. Which method we will use? Factorization method, completing square method, or quadratic formula. Any method you can use, your visually, because they are not mentioned in question which method. I'm going to use in here quadratic formula. Here A equal to, what is A? A means coefficient of x square, that is 1. B equal to coefficient of x is minus 3. C means constant term, minus 1. First find out b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac equal to, b square means minus 3 square. Minus 4 into ac, a in here 1. C is minus 1. 1 into minus 1. minus 3 square minus 3 into minus 3, 9, then minus minus plus 4 into 1, 4 into 1, 4. 9 plus 4, 13. You got b square minus 4ac is 13, that is positive number. You will get different two solutions. By quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This is quadratic formula. You can give all the values in this formula. Minus b is minus 3. Minus 3 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac, already got it, 13. Divided by 2 into a. A is 1. Minus minus plus plus 3 plus or minus root 13 divided by 2. We cannot find out square root of 13, isn't it? And write x equal to 3 plus root 13 by 2, or x equal to q minus also 3 minus root 13 by 2. Therefore, roots of given quadratic equation are, first root is 3 plus root 13 by 2, second root is 3 minus root 13 by 2. We got solutions. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Next question, Roman number 2. In here also, one condition given, x not equal to minus 4 and 7. In case x equal to minus 4, what will happen in here? 1 by minus 4 plus 4. 1 by 0 will get, minus 4 plus 4, that will be 0. 1 by 0 we cannot find out because that is not defined. Then, in case 7, given here 7, 1 by 7 minus 7, 1 by 7 minus 7, 0, 1 by 0 we cannot find out, isn't it? That is why x cannot be minus 4 or 7. Given equation, first we have to convert as quadratic equation. So, take LCM, left side. Here, x 4 minus. That given equation we can write as it is. Then take LCM. What is LCM? It is multiple x plus 4 into x minus 4. Then this 2, 1 into x minus 7 minus 1 into x plus 4. Equal to 11 by 30. 1 into x, x, 1 into minus 7, minus 7. Then using by minus 1, multiple, minus x, minus 4. All divided by a denominator, remove bracket, x into x, x square, x into minus 7, minus 7x. Then 4 into x, 4x. Minus, minus into, plus, minus, 4 into 7, 28, equal to 11 by 30. X minus x, that will be 0, then remaining, minus 7, minus 4, minus 11, all divided by x square, minus 7x plus 4x, minus 3x, minus 7 plus 4, minus 3, isn't it? Then minus 28, equal to 11 by 30. Just rearrange, that means this denominator bring to right side, this 30 bring to left side. minus 11 into 30 bring to left side means that will be division. Division change to multiplication into 30 equal to right side remaining only 11. 11 into this denominator bring to right side x square minus 3x minus 28. Then multiple 11 into 30. 3, you will get 330 equal to using by 11, remove bracket, 11 into x square, 11 x square, 11 into 3, 33 minus 11 into 28, 11, 8, 0, 3, 308. Then this minus 330 bring to right side. You can write right side what are things remaining? 11x square minus 33x minus 308. This minus 330 become plus 330. Then equal to, you can write 0. Actually 0 in here, the 0 we can write in right side also, it doesn't matter. Eleven x square minus 33x 330 minus 308. Then 10 minus 8, 2, then remaining 2. 2 minus 0, 2. Then 3 minus 3, 0, nothing. You will get 22 plus 22. Because 330 is big number. Now we got one quadratic equation. We can simplify this quadratic equation. Divide all the quadratic equation with 11. 11 divided by 11. In here 33 divided by 11. 22 divided by 11. Right side 0 divided by 11. Divided by 11. That time we will get 11x squared divided by 11. 33x divided by 11. 22 by 11 equal to 0 by 11. Just simplify that one. X square in here 3 minus 3x plus 2. 2 equal to 0 divided by 11. 0 will get. Then we got now simplest form of that quadratic equation. Now we can use quadratic formula. A. What is A? A in here 1. B is minus 3, C equal to 2. First we can find out B square minus 4AC. B square is minus 3 square, 4 into AC, C is 2. Minus 3 square, minus 3 into minus 3, 9. 4 into 1, 4 into 2, 8 equal to 1. 9 minus 8, 1. This is positive number. Positive number means we will get two different roots, isn't it? By quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac all divided by 2a. Just pause the video, write down. In this formula, give it all the values A, B, C. First, minus B. What is B? B is minus 3 plus or minus square root of B square minus 4AC, that is 1, divided by 2A. 2 into A, 1. Minus minus plus 3 plus or minus square root of 1, 1. 2 into 1, 2. Equal to, we can give that plus or minus separately. 3 plus 1 divided by 2 or 3 minus 1 divided by 2. Equal to 3 plus 1, 4. 4 divided by 2, or 3 minus 1, 2. 2 divided by 2. 4 divided by 2, 2. Or 2 by 2, 1. We got x values are 2 and 1. Therefore, roots of quadratic given quadratic equation are 2 and 1. This is our answer. Now we can see Roman number 3. In here one equation given, one condition also, x not equal to a, b. We cannot give in here a and b. If we give a and b, what will happen? Check it. A divided by, in here just give it b. B means b minus b. The place of x, just give it b. Then a divided by b minus b, 0. You will get a divided by 0. A divided by 0, not defined. Divided by 0, we cannot do. That is why b we cannot give. Then in case a means second part, b divided by the place of x, we can give a minus a, b divided by a minus a, 0. B divided by 0 we cannot do. That's why in this equation we cannot give a and b. First convert this given equation as quadratic equation. Here a divided by x minus b plus b divided by x minus a equal to 2. First take LCM. If you take LCM, you will get x minus b into x minus a. Multiple the denominators, then this 2. A into x minus a, then x minus b into b equal to 2. Remove bracket, a into x, x minus a into a square plus x into b, bx minus b into b, b square. X into x, x square, then x into a minus ax, minus b into x, minus bx, minus minus plus b into a, ab equal to 2. Now ax plus bx minus a square minus b square equal to 2. This denominator bring to right side, 2 into x square minus ax minus bx plus a. Then all the terms we can bring to right side. Before that, first remove this bracket using by 2. 2 into x square, 2x square, then 2 into minus ax minus 2ax minus 2bx minus, sorry, plus 2ab. Right side, just remove bracket using by 2. Then from left side, all the terms bring to right side. This ax become minus ax. Plus bx become minus bx. Minus a square and minus b square we can write. Plus a square plus b square. Then what is left side remaining? 0, equal to 0, isn't it? This 0 we just write right side. Now we can rearrange first 2x square. Then x term, you can see in here, minus 2ax minus ax. That we will get minus 3ax. 2a in here, 1a. Minus 2a minus a, you will get minus 3a. Then next, minus 2bx minus bx, you will get minus 3bx. Then constant terms, a square plus b square plus 2ab equal to 0. 2x square in these two terms. What is common? You can see x common, isn't it? Then minus 3. Take -3x outside. -3x. Then remaining a plus b. This minus already I took outside. Then a plus b. Then what is this? A square plus b square plus 2ab. A square plus 2ab plus b square. That is a plus b all square. A plus b all square. Again. Here we can use in here quadratic formula. That is a means coefficient of x square, that is 2. Then b means coefficient of x, this is x. Then coefficient of x we can write -3, then a plus b. X only just leave it, then remaining -3 a plus b will be coefficient of x. Then c means constant term, that is a plus b whole square. Now we can find out b square minus 4ac equal to b square. B means -3 a plus b whole square. B square minus 4 into ac. A in here 2. C is a plus b whole square. Minus square, minus into minus plus, then 3 square, 9. 9 a plus b whole square minus 4 into 2, 8. 8 a plus b whole square. 9 a plus b whole square minus 8 a plus b whole square. 9 minus 8, 1, isn't it? 1 a plus b whole square. We got now b square minus 4 ac. Now we can apply quadratic formula. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. By quadratic formula, first write quadratic formula x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Minus, what is b? B in here, minus 3 a plus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac, already we got it, that is a plus b all square. Divide by 2 into a. What is a? A is 2. This minus give inside minus minus plus 3 a plus b plus or minus square root and square cancel, then remaining a plus b. Divide by 2 into 2, 4. This plus or minus just give separately. 3a plus b plus a plus b divided by 4, or 3a plus b minus a plus b divided by 4. 3a plus b plus a plus b, in here 1 is there. 3a plus b plus 1a plus b, 4a plus b divided by 4, or in here 3 minus 1, 2. 2a plus b by 4. Cut it. 4 and 4. This 2 and 4, 2 times. You'll get a plus b, or in here a plus b divided by 2. We got solution. You can write therefore roots of a given quadratic equation are a plus b a plus b and a plus b divided by 2. These are the solution. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook.